here we are. We're out here at Paula, getting some riding in. So it's obviously, it's been a while, you know? Yeah. I mean, I broke my leg in Dallas last year, and just, never got back to 100% right away or as quickly as I thought, but yeah, just stoked to be riding a dirt bike. Yeah, I mean, at kind of that point, I wasn't expecting to get a call or, you know what I mean? Like, there was already seats, you know, it's the same game every year. But I had to figure out a way to go make some money, you know? Obviously, with not having an income after the factory deal was done, it was like, all right, what am I gonna do? And I still wanted to go out and have fun and ride, and you know, those events just like kind of popped up. Like, Barcelona kind of landed in my lap. So I was like, yeah, I'll go do that, even though I haven't rode Supercross in a while, so. And then the Robbie Gordon race, that was a cool one. And when they said they got like 15 grand up for grabs at Glen Helen, I was like, how can I not go do that? You know, like, it's just gotta make it happen. And I was just stoked to be able to go out and race. And, you know, I wasn't expecting any calls or anything like that. I just, you know, wanted to go out, make some money and have some fun.
Yeah, and then you did the Vet World Championship. You're the Vet World Champion.
Yeah, it's kind of weird to say that. I mean, I've never, once I realized, I was like, well, you know, plus 30, I could go race the vet class. So let's go do that. You know, it's like, there's gonna be life after the professional racing, and you know, it's kind of just a little bit of a glimpse of that, you know? Yeah, I do. Right now we're in the works of talking with Yamaha a little bit. You know, obviously Aaron got hurt at Daytona last weekend, and so there's opportunity to fill in for him. You know, obviously we haven't worked everything out, but we're still, you know, we'll probably have some news next week, just depending on how it all rolls together.
Yeah, have you been following the races? Like, when you saw that, I might get a call, and no,
you know, there was a couple opportunities that presented itself this beginning of the year, and I just didn't, you know, it wasn't right. You know, I've always been a guy that says, like, I'm not gonna go out and risk my life for nothing, especially when I have kids and a wife at home that I need to support. So a couple opportunities came up at the beginning of the year that I was, you know, like, thinking about until I realized we weren't gonna make any money, and I was like, well, it's not worth it. So yeah, just, you watch the races and you realize, oh man, somebody got hurt and here you go. And I was actually talking to Keith even before Aaron got hurt, just for the fact that I wanted to find a two-stroke to go race the National at Glen Helen, you know, just for another fun event. And Keith's like, yeah, we do. We got one, we'll help you out. And but I want to talk to you about maybe filling in. So that's kind of where it all started.
Today's your second day on the bike, I take it?
Yeah.
How's it feeling?
It feels really good. Obviously, you know, I've been on a Yamaha when I rode for JGR, and I think we're on the second or third edition of this factory bike, so I'm really surprised on the changes that they've made with it, even though I've been kind of out of the loop on the Yamaha for a while. But I'm really happy with it. I got on the bike. I mean, I didn't even change suspension or bars or nothing. I just literally hopped on, and I feel comfortable right away, so I'm stoked.
Man, you went from 09 at JGR winning on that Yamaha to the first year of the backwards frame bike.
Yeah.
That was, you know, like 4 feet wide. So, big difference, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's a lot different. I mean, they've made a lot of changes, and some stuff I don't even know. I just, like, kind of hopped on, like I said, and, you know, I'm pretty comfortable. So, excited to see if this opportunity, you know, goes along further and I'm able to go race for a little bit.
Cool. You've obviously stayed riding, stayed sharp. Have you been training? And you just went to class.
Yeah, I mean, after, I think it was after Monster Cup and after Barcelona, I went and did a works, you know, race or whatever, went to Havasu, had some fun. And then I hadn't rode since really right before Christmas. So I just got a bike back from Cowie a few weeks ago and went out to the turn track and one day, and then went out to Glamis, you know, a couple days ago. And really, that's all the riding I've done since early December. So, I mean, it hasn't been a lot. I mean, I've just been living life, dad life, you know, and making plans for the future. And that's all I can do, you know. But I'm not going out and riding a lot, training a lot to, you know, to be in that position. I've done that for 15 years, and it's like, I can't commit my whole life. You know, they got to start thinking of stuff after, so.
Yeah. I have a good friend, Gary, that says, once you got it, you never lose it.
I get that point. There's been times where I feel like, yeah, do I even remember how to ride? Because it's been 4 months. And then you get out there and you ride and, you know, you knock off the first hour and it's like, yeah, I'm here. I'm still here. So it's cool. It's a good feeling.
Okay, say this opportunity didn't present itself. What sort of things have you been doing to, earn a living to support your family? Is Hilton going well?
Yeah, Hilton's doing good. You know, we're still cruising along with that. Just been kind of working with my dad a little bit, getting the construction boots dirty, and just trying to, like I said, provide a life for my family and just keep working, you know. The racing thing, it's kind of hard to just commit the whole thing to it, and I'm just not at that point, you know. So just when these opportunities come up, I'll take full advantage of my opportunities in there and just see what happens.
I have to assume that the royalty from the JG Joey helmet have to be good, though.
Yeah, no.
It's the best looking helmet in their lineup.
What's cool is, you know, I've been with Joey my entire career. I think I've been, 25 years now in a Joey. So, it's been really well. Those guys have been behind me the whole time, and we're always stoked to come out with new stuff. And yeah, it's been awesome. Awesome relationship.
Hey, JG, it's awesome seeing you in action again. Hope everything works out.
Yep.
It should be awesome to have 33 on the line.
We'll see, hopefully.